kids. We are so excited for you to be joining us again today. It is going to be a good day. And today we have Ms. Lauren with us here, and we are so excited. But first, before we do anything, let's stand up and praise Jesus.
Heaven.
guys, what a great time of worship. I love those songs. They're so fun. But today, we're going to play a game. We're going to challenge each other to make things out of Play-Doh. But first, let's think about what we learned last week. Yes, we learned about the Ten Commandments last week, right?
Absolutely.
Yes, and so the second commandment is do not make an idol for yourself. Well, today we are going to learn about how the Israelites made an idol and sinned against God.
What are you thinking?
I know, it's craziness. So I'm going to challenge Miss Lauren to make a dollar bill out of Play-Doh. Because sometimes in today's world we can make idols out of, you know, things that we don't need to make idols out of, like money. Sometimes we put money before God. Sometimes we put our phones before God. And sometimes we put our relationships with other people before God. So, I challenge you to make a dollar bill.
I can do it.
All right. Let's see, she's going with green. Goodness, that looks just like a dollar.
Look at that!
I'm so impressed with your dollar. But I want to remind you, Miss Lauren, we don't make idols because we worship one God. All right,
sorry.
What are we gonna do to that?
Smash it up.
That's right.
Okay.
Now, let's see if I can make Miss Cat can make a phone.
Perfect.
Ta-da! There is my cell phone. See, sometimes we make idols for ourselves out of our phones and our communication with the outside world and social media.
Absolutely.
And that's not right, is it?
No, it's not.
So we're going to smash it.
Oh. No idols up in this house.
No, none. All right, guys, so now we're going to watch our video. So put your listening ears on and let's see what we can learn about the Israelites today.
God had delivered the Israelites from slavery in Egypt and from Pharaoh and his pursuing army. The Israelites came to Mount Sinai and they camped there in front of the mountain. Moses went up the mountain and God spoke to him. God had a lot to tell Moses, and Moses was up on Mount Sinai for 40 days and 40 nights. Meanwhile, the Israelites at the bottom of the mountain were getting impatient. They began to wonder, where is Moses? What is taking him so long? Is he still alive? The Israelites went to Moses' brother Aaron. Make us a God to lead us, they said. We don't know what has happened to Moses. So Aaron made a golden calf that they could worship. God saw what the people were doing and he was angry because of their sin. God told Moses to go down the mountain. I will destroy these people, God said. God told Moses to go down the mountain. I will destroy these people, God said. Please forgive them, Moses said. Remember the great promise you made to Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob? You promised to give them as many offspring as there are stars in the sky. You promised to bless them and give them land. So God decided not to destroy the people. Moses went down the mountain. He carried two stone tablets on which God had written the laws. Moses got closer to the camp and saw that the people were dancing before the golden calf. He threw down the stone tablets, smashing them at the bottom of the mountain. Then he destroyed the calf they made. What were you thinking? Moses asked Aaron. The people were out of control. The next day, Moses went back up the mountain to talk to God. "These people have sinned against you," Moses said. "Please forgive their sin." God told Moses to return to the people. "When the time comes, I will punish them for their sin," God said. Then the Lord sent a plague, a terrible sickness to the people because they worshiped the golden calf. God continued to meet with Moses and give him laws and instructions. He made two more stone tablets to replace the one Moses broke. One morning, Moses went up the mountain to meet with God. "The Lord came down in a cloud," he said. "The Lord is a compassionate and gracious God, but he will not leave the guilty unpunished." Moses bowed down and worshiped God. "Lord, please go with us," he said. "Forgive our sin and accept us as your people." God's people sinned against God, and Moses asked God to forgive them. Moses acted as their mediator, standing for them before God. Moses could not do anything to make up for their sin, but we have a mediator, Jesus. Jesus paid for our sin on the cross and stands for us before God. When we trust in Jesus, our sins are forgiven.
All right, guys, it is time for questions. It is time to dive deeper into that story and that video. A lot happened in there, and we have got to discuss it, okay? Yes. Are you ready, Miss Lauren?
I'm ready, girl.
Okay, all right, let's go.
So why did the people decide to worship an idol?
Well, the people decided to worship the idol because Moses went up to the mountain and then they assumed he wasn't coming back because it took him so long. He was up there just, you know, talking to God, but they didn't know that. They thought, oh, well, he's died up there and he's never coming back,
right?
So why did God choose to show the people mercy?
Well, Moses remembered God's promise to Abraham, and so he asked God to be merciful. So God's promises are always true, and we can talk to God and remind ourselves of his promises, and he is always faithful to do what he says he'll do.
That's right. Oh, that was good. Okay, so next question. Did God leave the Israelites' sin unpunished?
Not at all.
No, he didn't.
No, he promised to hold them accountable. Mm-hmm. And he should, because we do sin sometimes, and it is important that we are held accountable for what we do.
That's right.
Mm-hmm. All right. So how can God be both just and merciful?
Well, this is a tough question. Mm-hmm. And I even sometimes forget, you know, that God is just and he is merciful. But in our story today, God was just to punish the people for their sin, but merciful because he chose not to destroy all of them. Jesus is the perfect example of God's justice and mercy. Jesus took the punishment for sin so that we could enjoy God's mercy and forgiveness.
Thank goodness.
Mm-hmm, I know. Okay, so why does God command us to worship him alone?
Because God is the only one who deserves worship. He created everything, mm-hmm. and he has authority over everything.
So that's right.
Nothing he created is as good or powerful as him.
Mm-hmm.
So worshiping anything else is really just a waste of time and energy.
Yes, it is. Absolutely. Okay, guys, so now it is time for our next activity. So I want you to gather all anything you can make something beautiful with. Your crayons, your markers, your glitter, your glue, your scissors, your paper, all of it. Because today, our activity is just to make something beautiful.
All right, we've got some special helpers that are going to help us make something really beautiful today. This is Miss Madison, and this is Elijah. All right, y'all ready to get going?
guys, so I hope you made something extra beautiful. You know, God gave us creative minds, and He allowed us the ability to create things, not for us to worship, but to bring glory to Him. So I hope you have a wonderful week this week. We love you guys, and we hope to see you next week.
Bye. Bye.